I'm Joe.
And I'm Ben.
And we're the Bourbon Boys. Let's pour a glass.
Welcome back to Bourbon Boys. Glad to be here today again with his Georgetown College shirt on.
Yep.
We're watching football today.
Football.
It's halftime right now.
Halftime.
Pulling for Mr. C.J. Stroud right now,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, like C.J.
Stroud. Where we're at. But, so, this is a bottle here that, have we done the foolproof before? The barrel proof for Elijah Craig? I can't remember. We did Larceny, didn't we?
We did Larceny. I don't know if we've done All right. Elijah Craig.
So we're going to do the Elijah Craig today. And this is not just anyone. So this is the C923, which is supposedly the best one that they've had. And I see people doing blinds with this against, like, George T. Stagg and that ilk of bourbons. So I'm pretty excited. I was able to get a couple bottles of these. I've had this one for actually probably about a month and a half now. It's just been sitting there burning a hole in my pocket, so to speak. So I haven't cracked it open because I do buy these pretty much whenever I get a chance to, because they're
always pretty good.
Some are better than others, but they're always really good. But supposedly this is like the best batch, best one they've had. It's been all over the place. So this one has it's the highest proof one that I've had. It's 133 proof. And this has an age statement on it, which they've gone back to. Most other ones say 12-year, I think, on them. But this one is 13 years, 7 month, which is, again, the youngest bourbon that's in it. So it could have older ones in it. Probably does have some older ones. So we'll pour a little bit of this. And it's possible. We have a couple other bottles of this off to the side that we're going to compare it to because we hear such wonderful things about it. And I always enjoy these, though.
Man.
Oh, that's... that Great is nose. Nice. That's like... that's a big bruiser of a bourbon right there, isn't it?
Yeah.
We talk about, you know, the bourbon scents coming through, and this one just kills it, but it's so beefy on the nose. Ooh, that's nice.
Packs a good punch.
Yeah, it's got all the traditional bourbon things in there, and you get the char, the barrel a little bit, and it's just, I don't know, it's like talking to a big like a big lineman or something, right?
Man, that's great. Follows up on the.
And it follows up.
Taste.
Ooh.
Nice flavor.
Okay. You can tell it's got some heat on it.
A little bit, but.
But not, you wouldn't say 133, no. I mean,
holy cow.
It's not too much heat. It's just a really nice punch.
Yep.
From the heat and the flavor coming through. I believe this might be the best one of these that I've had.
So
I was a little, I mean, like I said, I think the Elijah Craig barrel proofs in general are
always pretty good.
Yeah, are great value at $60-ish, I think, in the $60 range, mid-60s, I think, with tax and such. And they just deliver most every time. This one is over and above, though.
Yeah,
it really is.
It's got a lot. It's giving you a lot.
I'm going to go in for one more.
One more?
One more? Well, I'm going to finish the whole ding-dang glass. Yeah, we're kind of late to the ball game on this one because lots of people have been talking about this. And rightfully so.
Yeah.
Rightfully so.
Yeah, I can see why.
That's wonderful. Just,
nice.
I like the finish. It has a nice... Like I said, it smells, has that just like a lot behind it. They're not out of the ordinary of notes, but they're just bang. I mean, bang.
Yeah.
on the nose.
Yeah.
And the flavor profile, it's the same flavor profile. It's just blends together perfectly. And the finish, wow, is that just still going?
Yeah, it lasts forever.
It doesn't. It's not even fading right now. It's just hanging right there. Just coat your whole mouth.
Nice Kentucky hug.
Oh, it's beautiful. We're going to finish this.
Absolutely.
Might take a minute, though.
Yeah.
Don't go nowhere.
Anyway.
We back?
We're back.
We're back. We're lamenting my wife and his mother-in-law. Right. Okay. Anyway, we're back. So we finished this off. And while we were gone, we also broke out two other batches, A121. And C, 921. So, anyway, because these, like I said, I get these most of the time. I will say this. It seems to me, in the at least last several years, and I do not try every single one of these that come out,
right.
But I try quite a few of them. It seems like the last batch of the year, the C batches, tend to be better than the other two. I don't know why that is, or if that's intentional, or if it's just my perception of it. But the Larceny, I think, follows the same thing. If I could pick one, I would take the C batch over the over the A and the B. But that's just my experience, and I don't know. Like I said, I haven't tried every single batch out there, so it's hard for me to say. But in this particular case, this one, the C923, is better because the A, was this the A?
Yeah.
Which is 123.6 proof. It's don't get me wrong, these are still pretty good.
Still but great.
This one, the A one, is kind of astringent, right?
Yeah.
And both of these have a much lighter nose and a lighter flavor profile with a little touch of fruitiness in it, right?
A little bit.
The C batch and both of these drink hotter than this one does, even though they're 10 and 13 proof points lower. But they drink hotter. This one drinks the hottest. And these both have a lighter finish than this one does.
Yeah, a lot shorter.
There's no question that this one is better than these two anyway.
Yeah.
But the C one, I would rank them this way like this. This one, and then the C, and then this one out of these three. Yeah. But we tried them in these little tiny glasses right here. Because these are high-proof whiskeys.
Yeah, we can't be
and it gets to you pretty quick.
No kidding.
But this one here, and as we were talking, there's no fruit on it, on the nose. There's no floral notes on it that I'm getting anyway. This is big, beefy, hearty bourbon, straight bourbon, man's bourbon. I don't know how to say it.
I think that's a good way to say it.
It's a little darker color, too, than these. And there's zero astringency to this. These have some kind of lighter fruity floral notes in them. This one has none, and there's no astringency. And even though this is a higher proof, as I was saying, that proof, you get that first sip, and the flavors just wash over is the first thing that you get. And then after you swallow, you get, like, this heat wave that kind of comes in and crest for a little bit and then just kind of plateaus off for the finish where most bourbons you get that and then the finish kind of goes at it like this. Even good ones, it might just be a low one like this, a nice finish. This one, like, just you get a steady plateau,
very steady
for a couple. It just goes on and on before it starts to
still,
fade.
I mean, it's still
fade off
going on a little bit.
It's fantastic. So I'm probably not telling anybody anything they don't already know, but if you get a chance to get this one,
definitely
this one
get that.
But I'm going to say anytime you see the Elijah Craig barrel proof ones, for the money, I don't know if you can get a better value than
the
this.
The money with that high proof point.
Right.
I mean,
so like I said, I didn't look up the actual retail value, but I think they're like $60. So with taxes, I think I paid like $65 for this one here, something like that. Okay. But I think it's in the $60 range. And these compete again with some of the best. I don't have a George T. Stagg to compare it to, or I would, but I don't have that. Like I said, if really light and sweet is your thing, this might not be your cup of tea. But if you like, and I like those too, I really enjoy those bourbons. But the variety is one of the things I like in
having
it.
Having a little bit of everything.
Right. This is a really beautiful bourbon. Balance. So I'll let you go first. I've been ratchet jumping on here because I'm.
I mean, so, yeah, to me, I mean, this is what a bourbon should taste like. I mean, this got everything that you would want in a bourbon. Those caramel, vanillas, a little bit of the char you can taste in there. It's great.
Oak. Not, just just enough oak with a little bit of the sweetness, the way you turn the caramels and the vanillas.
Yeah.
And it just balances very nice.
It's very good. So flavor-wise, I'm going to go with a 4.5. I think this one is one of the best we've had on the channel, I think.
I think so. Probably one of the best I've ever had, period, I think.
There you go. I mean, yeah, it's super good. And value-wise, I mean, I hate to give a 5, but man, 4.75, how about that?
You know what?
I mean, that's such a deal for the proof point, how long it's been aged. I mean, it's, yeah.
I think the flavor on this is at minimum a 4.5.
Okay.
And I think you go higher. I don't know what would make a 5 because you think then you're, what if you taste something that's better?
Right.
So you
have nowhere to
it's
go.
Hard. You got nowhere to go. Yeah. So I would go with this one, at least a 4.5.
Yeah.
Not that, but I'm going to give it a 5 in value because I don't know that you can. I don't know that I've found a better value than this one right here.
Yeah. I honestly don't know that I have. No, yeah. Absolutely.
So I'm going to give it a 5 for now. If I find a better one, we'll have to adjust.
Come back and.
But yeah, from when we first started doing this, I know I would give different values on them than I do now.
Yeah.
But this one here is the best value that I've had. I can't think of one that's a better value. And even though these come out, there still might be some floating around in stores somewhere. I don't know. You can find them on the secondary market. In this area, they're going for about $140, which is maybe these are $70. I should look and see, but. Anyway, it's nonetheless, it's a great value. It's well under $100.
Yeah.
And it's just a fantastic bourbon. So I would give this a 5, maybe.
Okay. That's it.
Like I said, the Weller Red at retail or the Foolproof at retail, if you can get it, those are ones that would be
right up there with it. Yeah, close to 5.
And they're sweet. It's a different profile, but.
Well, yeah, way different. Yeah,
way different profile. But totally this is fantastic. That's where I'm at. Anyway, so if you disagree with me, let me know.
Let us know.
But I don't think anybody will.
It's going to be hard.
Yep. If you got something better, let me know.
Because
I would love to try.
Please.
Thanks.
We'll see you.